So this is the molding toolpath on VcarvePro or Aspire. I came up with this using the molding toolpath. What I'm trying to do is to replicate the existing handrail. So what I'm going to do is to apply this molding toolpath to the stock. Then after we finish with the CNC router, we're going to put this on the shaper or the router to bevel the lower part so we could match this upper part, so we could have the edges are rounded all around like the one that they have right now. Let me show you a picture of the one they have right now.
So this is the existing molding of the handrail. This is the one that we need to replicate. It's a really old handrail. It's very simple, actually. It's rounded over on all the sizes. And it's 1.5 inches thick on the upper part. It's 3.5 inches wide. And it has this little design over here that we will try to replicate also on this upper part. Let's try that in Aspire. So let me show you how do I get here to get this molding pad. Let's start from zero so you can see how do we get here. First thing I'm gonna do is create a new file. The width of the material is 3.5 inches because that's the width of the handrail. So we're gonna put over here 3.5 inches, and the biggest one, there is actually two handrails, and the longest one is 96 inches long. So I'm gonna put over here 104 because I wanna have some material left over. Put some clamps maybe on the CNC router. So I'm gonna put over here 104 inches long. The thickness of the handrail is 1.5 inches. So I'm gonna put over here 1.5 inch, which is the same thickness of the stock that we are going to use. For the zero position, we're gonna use the material surface, and we're gonna put a double-sided job because we wanna make a pocket on the bottom to put an iron plate, which is gonna hold the handrail in place. So that way we could do the same thing with a replica and make a pocket on the bottom before doing the upper side. So let's go ahead and click OK over here. And the first thing we're gonna do is make a rectangle of the same side of the longest handrail that we want to make, which is 3.5 inches wide and 96 inches long. On the location, I'm going to put over here 0 on X, and because I want to left, you remember I put the long of the material 108, is because I want to left 4 inches on the bottom and 4 inches on the upper side. So I'm gonna put over here 4 inches. That way I'm gonna have 4 inches on each side of the stock left over so I could put some clamps on it. And create, okay. We have that one over here. Now we need to create a guide in order for our molding toolpath to work, we need to create a guide rail. What we're going to do is to this rectangle, we're going to make an offset, and we're going to make it, we're going to have it, the rectangle is actually right now 3.5 inches. We're going to make it like almost the half of it, which is 1 3/4 inches. So we're going to put over here to make an offset inwards of 1.745 inches. And let's hit OK. And we have this little rectangle who's going to be the guide rail. So the molding profile that we were going to do, that we are going to do, is going to, it's going to mount on this line, on this vector, and go all around making the actual molding. Let's see. You're going to see more detail later on. So let's start now making the actual profile that we need to do. You know already that the design is 3.5 inches. So I'm going to make a line of 1.75, which is half of it. 1.75 long. And the design is 1.5 inches thick. So I'm going to put over here 1.5 on this line. Actually, I shouldn't make this. Let's start over with 1.75 long line. Let's finish this one. I'm starting a new one, which has to be, the thickness of the material is 1.5 inches. But actually, what we have is 1 inch on the bottom and 1/2 inch on the upper side, on that curved side, upper side. So what we need actually is 1/2 inch plus, it's gonna be plus 1/2 inch for the upper side. It's gonna be just 1 inch. So we're gonna make a new line of 1 inch long. Now I'm gonna make a circle, a 2 inches diameter circle. I'm gonna put this circle, coincidence with this upper part. And then I'm gonna make another circle, which is 1 inch diameter, because I know the edges were made with a 1/2 inch bevel bit. So 1/2 inch and 1/2 inch on both sizes is 1 inch. So I'm gonna make another circle of 1 inch, and I'm gonna put it over here. And I'm just gonna move it now to the end of this line. Let me check the side of this. That's 1 inch. So I have to move this one. This one is 2 inches. Okay. Now I have 1 inch over here and 2 inches over here. Now I need to make another one, really small one, of 1.125, which is 1/4 inch. Sorry. And I'm going to put this one right here. Yeah, right there. Now I'm going to make a line. This all this look confusing, but you're gonna see why I'm making this in a little while. So I'm gonna make a line from here, an arc. It's gonna be an arc from here to somewhere around here, somewhere around here. And that will be fine. And okay, looks okay. Now I'm gonna trim all those lines that we are not going to need. Let me use the trim tool to cut all these over. This one, this one, this one. We don't need that one, we don't need that one. And this one, and over here, okay. Okay. So this is what we need, just this profile over here. Let's make it one line. Oh, it's already one line all together. So let's go to the molding toolpath. We're gonna make the molding toolpath. For that, I'm gonna leave over here gap above toolpath. I'm gonna leave 2 cents of an inch. I like to do that in case I have any variance of the thickness of the stock. So I don't want to miss any point on the toolpath. And I'm gonna use a bowl nose of 1/4 inch. Which I have already selected over here. You could go over here and change things, the settings for the cutting. I think what we have over here is okay, so I'm gonna hit okay. It says over here that we need to select the dry rails, and then with the shift key press, select the last vector, which is going to be the profile. So I'm gonna deselect this. Select this one. It's going to be the dry rail. And with the shift key, I'm going to select. This is going to be the profile. I don't want to start on this bottom side. I want to start over here on the upper side. So I will right click over here and reverse direction. And that will be up. So I could see over here that it's going to cut on the side that I want to. And it's that. Let's hit calculate over here. Next, for the purpose of creating a nice preview, let's make another toolpath, which is going to be the profile cut of the part all around. Actually, I'm not going to use that on the machine. I'm just going to cut it by hand. But for the purpose of the preview, let's cut it outside. I know that the thickness of the material is 1.5, so I put over here 1.5 to cut that. And I'm just going to hit OK. Just going to cut on the outside over here. And profile cut, I'm going to name this. Calculate. Okay, I'm gonna hit cancel because I didn't choose the right vector. It's the outside, the first rectangle that we use, that we created. That's the one that we need. Okay, calculate. Now I'm gonna do a preview all toolpaths. Let's see how it comes. Okay, this is what we have. I'm gonna get afraid of this leftover. This is what we have. Looks like the one that we are trying to replicate. And after we finish, I'm gonna put this through the shaper with the half inch bevel bit on the bottom, so I could have this run over all the way to the bottom. So I'm gonna make another video when we are making this on the CNC router and finally on the shaper. I hope you keep looking at my videos. I'm just starting this channel. So please, if you like the video, hit the like button, subscribe. I'm gonna be making videos of what we do on the shop, from the start point, the designing, to the process of the making, the actual part of the machine on the shop. If you like the video, please hit the like button and subscribe. I'm going to be making more videos. Actually, I'm going to make a second portion of this video showing how do I cut this part on the machine and finishing on the shaper. So please subscribe, and thank you very much for watching. Thank you.